Hello and welcome to the lecture on fast transpose idea. I would recommend you to watch all the previous lectures on sparse matrices and transpose of a sparse matrix before diving into this topic. Now let's get started. This matrix A, this representation of A, has to be now transposed to the matrix B. For this, the main idea is we find the number of rows for every column. I mean, if we take column 1, we will find the number of elements with column 1. If we take column 2, we will see how many elements are there in column 2. So, according to our transpose matrix B, for the transpose matrix B, now we will have number of elements in each row. This is the first information that we will collect. Number of elements in each row. The second information is, from this, it is easy for us to find the starting position of every non-zero element in the sequence 1 to t, where t is the number of non-zero elements. Let me explain. We will be constructing two arrays S and T. What is S? S is the number of non-zero elements in the first row of B. Okay, for B, this is corresponding to B. In first row of B, we have 1 and 2, 2 elements. In second row of B, we have 1 element. In third row of B, we have third column elements of A, right? So 1 element again. So similarly, in fourth column of B, we have 2 elements. See here, we have 2 elements, 4 and 4. So 2 elements. In fifth column of B, fifth row of B, we don't have any elements. It's a 0. And sixth row in B, we have 1 element again. Right? So there is a total of 8, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Did I miss any number here? There is a 3 here and there is a 3 here. So this should be 2. 2 elements in third row of B. So okay. So this is the rows. Number of rows. First row 2 elements, second row 2 elements, so the total is 8, right? Now we are correct. Now what is T here? Okay, so the first non-zero element is at position 1. Okay, after we have 2 more elements, there are 2 elements in the first row, so first and second position will be filled. Now the third row, third position of this sequence will be filled with this 1 element. Then we have fourth position to hold first element and fifth position for the second element. Now we have sixth position for this 2 elements. After these 2 elements occupy 6 and 7, then we have eighth position. But in 8, we don't have any element. So in eighth position, we will have the sixth row element. Now look at this, we have an array from 1 to T. We have found the exact positions where we have the non-zero elements. We have got the exact positions where we have the to store the non-zero elements. So what do we mean by this? We need not traverse all the positions of this triplet array. We can traverse only the required positions. We are saving a lot of time here, and according to this algorithm, we see that the complexity is n plus t. N plus t. How is it n plus t? First, we need to calculate s. This s, okay? So to calculate s, we will be iterating 1 to t times. Okay, so this is to calculate s. So to calculate t, we will be iterating 1 to n times. So we have n plus t as the complexity here. Okay, so the order of n plus t. So this is the complexity of fast transpose algorithm. To look into more details, please visit the textbook by Ellis Horowitz, Fundamentals of Data Structures. There is a detailed algorithm which explains each and every step that is mentioned here. Thank you.